Hello. In this video, let's take a look at AWS CLI and how we can use it to interact with AWS services. AWS CLI is the command line tool which is used to interact with AWS services, right? As we can see on the screen, I have the AWS console open. And in the previous video, I did go over different ways to and means you can interact with AWS services. The console is one of the ways, and CLI would be something that you would install on your local machine so that you can start sending commands from your shell directly to the AWS console and start interfacing with AWS services. Let's take a look at that in this video. And in this video, we'll go over setting up the command line interface. We'll configure the command line so that we can start interacting with AWS services. And we'll go over an example on the AWS how-to guides so that we can start working, have a real-world example or real example. In this case, it would be the example of executing batch upload files to Amazon S3 using AWS CLI. We'll go over the how-to guide in which we will set up a user and that we will configure on our local machine and use that to start sending commands to Amazon S3 service. So let's start with installing and configuring the service first. So in this case, we're gonna go on the command line interface documentation and install it in my case, it's gonna be Mac OS. So I'm gonna install it for all users. And these are the commands I'm going to execute, which will install the AWS CLI v2 package and configure and set it and have the CLI working on my machine. All right, so let's start with installation. All right, the AWS CLI is installed and it's working. So now let's try and interface with AWS S3 service. And if you want to list all your buckets in your account, so you want, the way you can do that is you can put AWS, that would be the CLI, as we can see when we used it for getting the version here. So, and then I'm going to say S3 is the service I'm going to use and I'm going to list buckets. In this case, it would be the command name is SLS. So I'm going to execute that. Okay. So in this, it's not going to work because we have not configured the credentials for any user on my machine here so that it can start it will have the authentication and the authorization to actually interface with the services, right? So let's go ahead with setting that up and configuring it. Before we configure it, how do we actually, what are the different ways you can set up the credentials? Let's take a look at those. So there's two ways to do it, which are the most common ways. One would be to set up the credentials file. As we can see, we'll set up the tilde, which is the home directory .aws/credentials file. And it is more like an INI format file. And we'll set up the name of the profile. And then we'll put in the access key ID and the secret access key. And there's other values you can put in there as well. You can put in the output. You can put in the default region for that profile. And that would be something that you can reference in your CLI calls. So in this case, here we see that we have a default profile and we have a user one profile. So if you wanted to do a default profile, the command that I used here would be good enough. We can say S3LS. In this case, we're trying to use S3 service. So it would by default use the default profile. Right? But if you had to use another profile, and it's not configured on my machine, but the way I would do it is I would say profile and the name of the profile, in which in this case we see it's user one. So I would just say user one, and then it would use the user one profile to start interacting using that account to start interacting with AWS. Another file that is of relevance is the config file, where some of the things that you can reference in that file would be the region and the output as discussed here. A few other ways to interact with or set up AWS profiles. One of them would be to set up, use the configuration files. Like the CSV files can be directly imported and imported into setting up the command lines as well. There's more on that in the documentation. I'll put the links for those on the video so that you can take a look at those as well. So now we have installed the CLI, and then we have taken a look at how we want to configure the CLI, right? So let's take a look at this example. In this case, what we're going to do is we're going to set up a user on my AWS account so that the user will provide us with some credentials which we can use to start interacting and using the CLI. It's a tutorial on the how-to guide. I'll add the link for this as well. It's a very good beginner tutorial to get started. So the step one would be we need a user to start using services. We'll go ahead and create that user here. So what we're doing here is we're going to the IAM service, which is for identity and access management. And in that case, we are going to click on users and we're going to create a user who has administrator access, and then we'll get those credentials to start using on my machine. So let's do that. So let's use the IAM service. Users. We're going to create a user. I'm going to say that's the name of the user. Attach policies directly, and I'm going to say administrator access. Next. I'm going to leave this as is. I'm going to delete this user after this video creation is done, so I'm not going to worry much about setting up the tags or setting up the permissions and stuff. Right. So now let's create the API keys or the CLI keys that we're going to use on my machine for this very user here. So go to security credentials and we're going to create access key. And in this case, it would say, okay, you plan to access keys. Use these access keys to enable AWS CLI to access your AWS account, which is what I am intending to do here. So I understand the above recommendation. I'm going to proceed. And I'm gonna skip the tag part because as I mentioned, I'm gonna delete this account, this user. Okay, I have created an access key and a secret key now. So let's configure it on my local machine. So one of the ways you can configure your CLI would be to do AWS configure, and it would set up that file, the AWS credentials file. We'll take a look at that after we have done configuring this. So we have the access key here, the secret key for this user. The for region, I'm going to use Northern Virginia, which is US East 1. The for output format, I'll leave it at text. Okay, so now we have created this, done AWS configure. So if you do look at tilde AWS credentials file, we have inputted those credentials that we just created like a few seconds ago. So the CLI is configured and CLI is installed. So let's start using it as we have used it in that example. So if we have done the user creation part and we have attached the policy that they have mentioned here, which is administrator access. And now we have done the installation of the CLI part as well prior to going through this tutorial. So we'll move to step three, which is using AWS CLI with Amazon S3. So in this case, what we are doing is we are creating a bucket. As listed here in this note, the bucket name is globally unique. So the bucket name listed here, which is my first backup bucket, is probably not going to be available for us. So I'm going to use some random name and use that bucket as for this example. What is some random characters at the end. Hopefully that is unique. All right. The make bucket has successfully completed. We move on to the next part of the tutorial. All right. Let's upload the file. So from one of my directories, and then we say S3 CP. All right. So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to download and upload this specific file from one of my folders and upload it to the bucket that we just created. And this bucket name, as we see in the example, we're going to copy it to the S3 bucket directly and reference it here. All right, so I've successfully uploaded the file in this case. So now I am in this next example, I'm going to download that specific file from the bucket itself. So we're going to go to the bucket, look at the file that we just uploaded and downloaded to the local location. Right, let's download it to my downloads folder here. In this case, we see the downloaded file on downloads, which was not the original initial location. So here's an example of downloading the file as against to just uploading it as well. So we just uploaded, we created a bucket, we uploaded a file to that bucket, we downloaded a file from that bucket. So now we're going to delete the file which we have uploaded to the bucket, and then we'll try and list all the buckets that are in our account as well as an extra step here, right? So I'm going to remove the file. In this case, I'm going to remove, we are going to use the s3rm command, and I'm going to reference the exact file that I want to remove here, right? So very similar to our copy command. So we'll do aws s3rm. This is the file which we're going to remove. So let's remove that. Okay, so we have deleted the file. So let's see, and this is a list command for all the buckets that we have in the account, which is something that we tried to use in our tutorial in this video of initially, and we're not able to run it because the CLI was not configured. So this is an example of using all the AWS CLI commands for Amazon S3 service and setting up and getting it working on your local machine. I hope you like this video, and please come back for more tutorials and videos like these. Thank you so much.